So Citron Research, a company that basically is a short sell activist, I believe is how they title themselves. He reports specifically on and investigates fraud in the stock trading in publicly traded companies. And there's some links I'm going to go ahead and leave below, who is Citron Research. You can read about them on Wikipedia, Mr. Andrew Left. But what brings me even to talk about this is Citron exposes Ubiquiti Networks. They didn't want Citron exposing their fraud, so guess what they're going to do? Expose another fraud. A little bit of a salacious title. The guy is kind of passionate about, he thinks that Ubiquiti's a giant fraudulent company, and they're like some of these other companies that he's reported on where they're plugging the numbers and manipulating stocks and doing all this stuff. But here's where I call a little bit of shenanigans on this. Now, he does talk about them having a better margin than some of the other companies that are in their market, like let's say Cisco. And it's their key metrics. Then he talks about red flags. I know I don't like buzzwords myself. We've all heard them. A disruptive biz model, shady distributors, and we have a different this and different that. I see all the things in there, and he's got some quotes pulled out by Pearson's. And Mr. Pearson Canadian Valiant's business model was not fully understood by all investors, but he had nothing to be ashamed of. And he's trying to point that, the CEO of Ubiquiti seemed to admire someone who's a CEO of someone else who was frauding. Those are kind of reaches and things like that. Silicon Valley and that whole world is a little bit of a bubble. And, we poke fun of them at the show that came out called Silicon Valley. But back to the topic here. So he tries to make a case that Ubiquiti is just a giant fraudulent company. They were talking about Ubiquiti sales to this location, that location, this one's in Poland. They're a distributed company, and that means they're not exactly one big central company like you think of Cisco, where you have one large office building and things like that. So Ubiquiti choose not to disclose any profit or EBIT margins by region. However, applying this phrase, and if you're not familiar with that is basically they're not breaking down. They break down the company as a whole, but not individually as each region are operating in. But like I said, I'll leave the link to the report so you guys can read all that. But this is where this guy really loses me, and this is also why I'm doing this. So, I don't have anything against the guy, but I'm not clear the whole thing with Ubiquiti because they sell a tangible physical product that we've installed an absolute ton of, and we like them. Their products work. That's why we're pretty passionate about them. So this is the part where he does lose me a lot.
Community, as we see, this community is described as highly engaged and loyal evangelists. Yes, evangelists. So we're supposed to believe that Ubiquiti, people that buy routers, people that buy access points, are so obsessed with them. Not like, I understand if someone buys a Tesla and tells everyone, oh my God, this
loyal evangelists. Let's just say if there's something tech people absolutely are, is we're loyal evangelists about the technology we love. So for him using that Ubiquiti's having an engaged community as a bragging point for their system, that's a bad thing. I'm like, what are you nuts? Like, this is exactly what all tech people are. We are really crazy loyal evangelists about the tech we love. It looks like a religious debate, minus the religion. When you talk about, Linux distributions, desktop environments we use, products we choose in tech, especially like anything for security or in this case, wireless deployments, you will have people who will everything but punch each other over this. You'll watch heated debates in forums. Now, and if you go to the community.ubiquiti, they have done a good job with community. You look at these posts. There's some big numbers in here. There's a lot of discussion. It's very active going on. There's a lot of other people besides me making videos and talking about their products. And why are we doing it? Because we're preaching about the products because we're so happy with them. We've been installing Ubiquiti since 2013. So I'm a little concerned that there could be something wrong there. I'm not exactly a finance guy who knows stocks well enough to read his stuff and say that's valid. There's already been some rebuttals on this. And there is interesting things about Ubiquiti as a company. They don't seem to have the normal company structure that we're used to. And while I would say that would be a red flag, like he says, the other thing is I physically, tangibly have their products in my hand, in use, and deployed. So you can say all you want about the company, but I'm holding product and I'm they've been around since 2005. So now we've got 12 years in business, and we have, you know, deployed tons of their equipment everywhere. Now, one of the things that makes Ubiquiti so much different than, and I have this page pulled up, like, you know, the Merakis from Cisco and things like this, is pricing. Yes, Meraki is an interesting product, but they're old school thinking that I don't care for. Now, I don't mind paying fees for services or support. That's understandable. But for the business model that they have over at Cisco is like, oh, no problem. You need a license every year. And by the way, you can only use our controller that we control. And if Cisco decides or has a problem, because tech companies have problems, and there's a problem with their cloud server, screw you, because you can't access the devices. You're only kind of renting devices from them, you know, so you got to pay so much per year annually, or they just turn themselves off. I don't like that business model, and I know a lot of other technical people feel that way too. Ubiquiti gives away the software that manages the product. They let you download it. They build a device. You can run your own cloud stack and not have to give Ubiquiti any more money from when you buy the device. Now, from a Wall Street perspective, that's a scary business model, because people want to know what the long-term recurring revenues and everything else and doing that. But other people like myself go, I want to be able to buy it and own it. And if the company has a problem, maybe, you know, this guy's on the off chance he's actually right and Ubiquiti falls apart. You know what won't fall apart? All the stuff that I have. Because I bought it, I don't have any recurring licensing for it. I would lose support for it, and obviously there wouldn't be any more updates, but that gives me a transition period. If Cisco Meraki were to close up shop, all those endpoints would just go stop because they're locked into their cloud. And Meraki did have an incident that, you know, shook people a little bit. They had a little incident in their cloud center that caused some resets of all the data. And that really has these big companies thinking, going, wait a minute, we did everything perfect. And think about this from a company standpoint, you know, large corporate entity. They do everything perfect. Their IT, everything's checked, everything's done right, but the cloud controller at Meraki messes up and broke our internal network. That's a scary thing. I mean, Cisco's a strong company that does things generally right, I think, like the quality of security and things like that. I'm just not a fan of their licensing fees. But when you look at that, that's a scary proposition versus Ubiquiti. And if they went out of business, I'd tell my clients, look, these products, there's not going to be updates anymore. We'll look for the next product that will fit the bill and transition to it. There's an easier answer. And if we screwed up our cloud controller, we can hold our own feet to the fire because we screwed it up. So it is a different business model for them. And I think that scares a lot of companies. It makes them look a little different. This guy also points out the, you know, empty buildings. And I think that's just a misconception for these. You know, you look at the Linux Foundation, and I'm going to point them out because I have a friend that works there. They have lots of workers around the world. They don't need a giant building to stick everyone in. That's the old way of thinking. That's the old business model. You don't need this huge, you know, big building where you put everyone together to make things work. We have better ways to communicate than ever, and they keep getting even more enhanced. You don't have to be in the same building together, so I don't really get that argument that he's making. Granted, it seems odd, and it would be odd for a publicly traded company to be that way, you know, as far as statistically odd, but not odd as in it can't be done. It's being done. And I don't know. I'm not a big fan of this guy's whole really out there. Is he just trying to make a name for himself and calling this company out? Is there something there? I don't know. I'm going to keep an eye on the story. But I'm still ordering Ubiquiti products. Nothing says I should stop ordering it. Their stock did take a hit. This was a big hit to them as far as, you know, the whole thing. But that's life. Hopefully they, you know, comment on this. Right now, Ubiquiti's remaining silent on this. But they don't really have, as I understand, as he points out, they don't have a big PR team to really address this. They're probably going to rely on the community. And I feel as though I'm part of that community. And I'll stick up for Ubiquiti. You know, I can't really comment on the numbers things. That's not my field of expertise. But their product is real. It's physical. It's in my hands. We've deployed a ton of them. And we've had an amazing track record of success for all the stuff that we've deployed. It just works wonderful. And they keep releasing updates. They just released another update for some more software. So the company's actively cranking out new product, new updates. That sounds good to me. Still active engagement in their forums. And there's an active discussion not being commented on Ubiquiti, but they're allowing it to occur on their forums about this whole thing right here with links and all that. I can leave a link to the community one there. But I do find it funny that he disabled comments for his. So he's like, comments disabled for this video. So, you know, while Ubiquiti's engaging comments, he clearly doesn't want any on his video, which I don't get. Like, why would you not want comments on here. So anyways, that's my thoughts on the Ubiquiti Citron Research thing. I'll keep the, if there's an update to the story, I will certainly comment and whatnot on it. Check out my channel for other Ubiquiti stuff on there. And I already see popping up here another person I subscribe to. We've got Crosstalk Solutions and also Willie Howe. We've also done a lot of videos on these. And you can see the, you know, Linus Tech Tips as well. I know he's done them. All of us, we have nothing but wonderful things to say about all these Ubiquitis on there. So something to think about. I think they have a good product, and I think this guy might be full of a little hot air. He may have been right on some things, but I don't know if he's right on this one here. So, hey, thanks for watching. If you like the content here, like and subscribe.